So what are the five best investments that you can do, and that you can do especially if you're young? In this video, we are exactly going to talk about these five top investments that I think are top investments. Hey, it's Dario and this is Divity Finance, a platform where we can share our best tips and tools when it comes to trading, investing, or finance in general. And if you love the subject, please consider subscribing. So the first investment that we can do is pay off our debts. I know, it's not a true investment, but it's actually important. So let me talk about it. We already talked about debt and what is debt. And we said that there are two types of debt. There is a debt that makes value or keeps value, such as buying a house or buying machinery for our company. And then there is another type of debt that doesn't make any value. Actually, it doesn't even hold value and loses value. Those are debts that are used to buy things such as cars or using credit cards or going for holidays. So all of these things don't hold value, actually they lose value, especially cars because they are extremely expensive. So these type of debts should be paid off as soon as possible. And if you can do that, immediately. You need to imagine that as being like an iron ball, those ones that were put on the legs of the prisoners back in the days, something like that, that doesn't make you go forward, financially speaking. So, if you can get rid of that ball as soon as possible, you will be free to reach your financial goals. If not, you will be very, very much slowered. The second investment is education. I know many of you will just be bored right now and many of you already closed the video, but it's important. I know you want me to talk about stocks and you want me to talk about funds and all that, but education is actually very, very important. It's both important education in terms of investment education, so financial education, so then you can invest, but also professional education, raising your knowledge, okay, being a little bit better than your colleagues, knowing a little bit better than your colleagues, puts you in an advantageous position, makes you stand out, making your curriculum a little bit bigger, makes you be rare, okay, makes you be different. And when something is rare, it costs more. Of course, be careful, you cannot go and specialize on the formation of onions. You need to specialize in something that your clients or that your potential new companies where you wanna work at are gonna like and actually they are interested in. So no onions, go for something that your clients or companies are actually interested in. And of course, if you are interested in those things, it's much better as well. Actually, you should focus on the things you are interested in. Now, to gain education, to gain knowledge, there are many ways. There is the practical way, first of all. So you just take Excel, okay? You just do a spreadsheet, a fake spreadsheet, to learn the formulas, okay? The Excel formulas. Then, of course, we have online courses. So online courses are very helpful. Not all of them are too expensive. You can find them very easily and you can learn a lot from them and you can learn from home. Then you have presence course. So a course where you actually go there. Maybe they are at night or late evening. Okay. So it's also fairly easy to participate in these courses if you already have a job. And then of course at the top of the top we have diplomas or certifications. These are for example the CIAT for the Italian financial analyst or the IFTA again for financial things. But then also we have like the participation in organizations, for example the ICE for civil engineers in the UK, that also requires you to surpass a certain amount of requirements. So all those things will make your curriculum pop out and will make your curriculum be a little bit bigger, be a little bit better. And all those things are actually very, very important. And we will talk about this professional education. But yes, they are very important to make you stand out, to make you be better. And finally, to have a bigger salary or to give out a bigger bill. The third investment is a retirement plan. Again, I know you want me to talk about funds and blah, 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 but a retirement plan is actually important. It's much more important a retirement plan than actually investing in any stocks or any funds. A retirement plan is actually very similar to it, but it's made with a purpose, okay? It's made with a pension purpose, the purpose to go on retirement. We already know that the tendency of financially evoluted nations is the one where the population can decrease or slower in growth rate, and actually the amount of older people, the amount of elderly, can even surpass the amount of younger people, and therefore there is not this recycle in generations. And this is very dangerous when we talk about national pensions, okay, government pensions, because we will still go on and on and on, and the amount of pension that we young people are gonna receive is gonna be smaller and smaller and smaller, to the point where there could even be no pension for us. Therefore, if the nation or the government cannot think about our pension or our retirement, then we need to think about it. So we are responsible for our retirement, and we are responsible for how we are going to live, financially live, in our retirement. And that means thinking about it privately, and that means making a retirement plan. The fourth investment that I would do is an accumulation plan. By accumulation plan, I simply mean a plan to invest a certain amount of money every month. Now, it's not necessarily advisable to actually invest every month, because it requires a lot of costs. You know, every time you make an investment, you need to pay those commission costs. So maybe you take away every month from your salary a certain amount of money that can be $100, $150, a very small amount, okay? And then every 6 months, every 12 months, you decide to invest that amount of money in your portfolio. And that's called an accumulation plan. That's simply because you don't start actually with a big amount of money. That would simply mean that you need to waste a lot of years to wait for that big amount of money to be there. Instead, you start immediately investing and using the compound interest to gain even more money. And then you do that periodically, so that at the end of your investment, that can be 10, 20, 30 years, you will have the sum of money that you desired, or of course something similar. This is extremely necessary, of course, if you don't have a big amount of money to invest. As we said before, the accumulation plan is made exactly to not invest a lot of money initially. So you just take a small amount of money, and you do that periodically for a lot of years, and at the end you will have a big sum of money, hopefully. So how you do an accumulation plan, I cannot explain you how to do that in this video, because it's very personal. What I can tell you is that normally you would want to do it with ETFs, okay? No specific stocks, no actively managed funds and all that. Just go with ETFs. Don't ask me which ETFs or which indices to invest in, because again, it's something personal that has to be discussed with a financial advisor, or even by yourself, you can do that, but you need to understand what are your risks, what are your goals, and what are your needs, okay? So all those things need to be taken into account. So unfortunately, I cannot talk about it right now. But making your money grow, making your capital grow, is extremely important. We know that liquidity is an investment. Keeping your money in the bank is a choice of investment, and is a choice of investment that will make you lose money due to inflation. We already talked about it many, many times. So we need to invest our money in the true economy, in companies mainly, okay? So this can be done through many ways. But yes, we need to take a little bit of that true economy, that evolving economy, growing economy, to make our capital grow as well. So that's very, very important. Now, the last investment, the fifth investment that I would like to talk about, I put it at the end simply because it's not extremely necessary for young people or people that don't have big responsibilities. I'm talking about people that don't have a house, or they still live with their parents, or people that don't have a family to maintain, and so on. What I'm talking about is an emergency fund. Due to coronavirus, we learned that losing your job from a day to another, it's actually possible. Even more possible is that your salary is going to drop one day after the other. If those things can happen, it's better to have an emergency fund. An emergency fund is simply an amount of money that we have in the bank or somewhere where we can access it easily, a liquidity sum of money that we can use to then sustain our life with the same standards. So our lives should not be changed, and that is for at least 6 months, I would say. Now, of course, the 6 months, so the period of time, depends kind of highly on the nation where you live in. So if you live in a nation where it's actually easy to find a job, or you know, the job that you would find doesn't change your salary too much, so such as the USA or Switzerland, for example, where it's actually easy to find a job, then it can also be like 3 months, 6 months. But if you live in a nation such as Italy, or I don't know, other nations where it's hard to find a job, or where it's hard to find a job with the same salary as before, then you should think about more like 6 months, 8 months, even 12 months. All those things should be taken into account when you build a fund, an emergency fund. How do you build an emergency fund? Very simple. You just take a portion of your salary, so I don't know, $100 to $100 every month, you put it in this emergency fund, in this account, bank account maybe, and then you leave it there until it grows to the desired amount of money. Once it grown to the desired amount of money, you just keep it there. Remember, if you change your lifestyle, if you increase your rent, or you buy another house, you need to put that change into the emergency fund as well. So you need to grow the emergency fund a little bit more. And that's it. So these are my 5 top investments that you can do right now, especially if you're young. But let me know, what are your best investments? What is your best investment that you would share with all the others? What is the thing that you would absolutely do, especially if you're young? So this is all I had to say about these 5 top investments that I think are top investments. But hey, as I said before, let me know what you think. And if you like the video, leave it a like. I would highly appreciate that. And if you haven't done it already, please subscribe to the channel. You will not miss out on any further video. And I will see you in the next video. Asset allocation, asset reallocation, diversification. Yes, thank you, but what are those terms? What do they mean? And how do they work? In this video, we're gonna see exactly that, especially for diversification, because you will be surprised to know that there is a specific way for diversifying. It's not like